Candy apples are a pretty sight in the Western countries during fall season, Halloween or even in fairs. Kids get easily tempted by their pretty looking sight. They are also known as toffee apples. My daughter was very interested in making her own candy apples. Sometimes I just take a shortcut and melt some store-bought candies like red cinnamon candy. You can also make candy apples with any other color candies. In fact, in the recipe below, just change the food color and add some different flavors. So here is the recipe. Candy apple ingredients: Granny Smith apples, 4 sugar, 1 cup corn syrup, 1/4 cup water, 1/3 cup red food color, 1/2 of a teaspoon method. Wash the apples and pat dry. Insert a lollipop stick or popsicle stick or wooden skewer in the center of each apple. Candy apple steps: place the apples on a cookie sheet lined with parchment paper or wax paper. Combine the sugar, water, corn syrup and red food color in a saucepan. Bring to a boil and cook for almost 20 minutes. Switch off. If you have a candy thermometer, it should show 300 degrees F. Take one apple at a time and carefully dip into the candy mixture, swirling around to coat all sides. Lift it and hold it for a few seconds so that the excess candy mixture drips off. Place the candy coated apples on the cookie sheets to let the candy cool and harden. Candy apples are a pretty sight in the Western countries during fall season, Halloween or even in fairs. Kids get easily tempted by their pretty looking sight. They are also known as toffee apples. My daughter was very interested in making her own candy apples. Sometimes I just take a shortcut and melt some store-bought candies like red cinnamon candy. You can also make candy apples with any other color candies. In fact, in the recipe below, just change the food color and add some different flavors. So here is the recipe. Candy apple ingredients: Granny Smith apples, 4 sugar, 1 cup corn syrup, 1/4 cup water, 1/3 cup red food color, 1/2 of a teaspoon method. Wash the apples and pat dry. Insert a lollipop stick or popsicle stick or wooden skewer in the center of each apple. Candy apple steps: place the apples on a cookie sheet lined with parchment paper or wax paper. Combine the sugar, water, corn syrup and red food color in a saucepan. Bring to a boil and cook for almost 20 minutes. Switch off. If you have a candy thermometer, it should show 300 degrees F. Take one apple at a time and carefully dip into the candy mixture, swirling around to coat all sides. Lift it and hold it for a few seconds so that the excess candy mixture drips off. Place the candy coated apples on the cookie sheets to let the candy cool and harden. Candy apples are a pretty sight in the Western countries during fall season, Halloween or even in fairs. Kids get easily tempted by their pretty looking sight. They are also known as toffee apples. My daughter was very interested in making her own candy apples. Sometimes I just take a shortcut and melt some store-bought candies like red cinnamon candy. You can also make candy apples with any other color candies. In fact, in the recipe below, just change the food color and add some different flavors. So here is the recipe. Candy apple ingredients: Granny Smith apples, 4 sugar, 1 cup corn syrup, 1/4 cup water, 1/3 cup red food color, 1/2 of a teaspoon method. Wash the apples and pat dry. Insert a lollipop stick or popsicle stick or wooden skewer in the center of each apple. Candy apple steps: place the apples on a cookie sheet lined with parchment paper or wax paper. Combine the sugar, water, corn syrup and red food color in a saucepan. Bring to a boil and cook for almost 20 minutes. Switch off. If you have a candy thermometer, it should show 300 degrees F. Take one apple at a time and carefully dip into the candy mixture, swirling around to coat all sides. Lift it and hold it for a few seconds so that the excess candy mixture drips off. Place the candy coated apples on the cookie sheets to let the candy cool and harden. Candy apples are a pretty sight in the Western countries.